All right, so I wanted to get into this because it's kind of been an underlying issue past week or so. And that's this idea of morals. According to the dictionary, morals are pertaining to or concerned with the principles or rules of right conduct, or this distinction between right and wrong. Now, we were talking about religion, which is how this came to being, and some people said, well, as long as I have good morals, am I the same as a religious person? And we brought you the story where a lot of atheists are sending their children to school to learn moral behavior, and what makes somebody moral? And I have this position where if you make up your own morals, you're really not moral at all. And I'm not going to say you're a bad person. I'm not. You're just not moral. Morals have to come from something bigger than ourselves. Some people think it's the state. Some people think it's God. Some people think it's collective society. Whatever it is, it has to come from something bigger than yourself. Because in the very definition, we find some problems. What if it was moral behavior to have four wives? And don't say, well, Josh, that can't be moral behavior. Well, if we get to make up our morals, sure it can. Do you think nations or cultures, whatever, countries with that system, with a polygamous system, do you think they're being immoral? No. No, matter of fact, they're being moral by having multiple wives. Well, then if we're going to be freedom lovers and, you know, hey, you know, freedom for everybody, then we have to say, well, wait a second. Is it really immoral then for him to do that? And see, that's where we have a problem. You know, cannibals, it was moral for them to kill their neighbors and eat them. And here we would say, oh, you know what, that's not moral. You can't argue that that's moral behavior. Well, sure you can, and that's the point. Because for those people, the definition of right and wrong, if the neighboring colony was your enemy, you could kill them and eat them. That's moral behavior. Well, then the knee-jerk reaction would be, well, Josh, you know that's not what I'm talking about. Oh, then what are you talking about? Well, I'm talking about like American morals. Like what? Well, you can't kill your neighbor. Oh, that sounds familiar. I heard that someplace before, thou shalt not kill. And, you know, you can't lie about people. Oh, so you can't bear false witness. I heard that too. See, even if you think you're an awesome atheist and you get your moral value from something else, in reality, you're just picking up on existing morals from existing systems and saying, okay, this is something that I want in my moral arsenal. But they still came from something bigger. And that's why this conversation is such a tricky one. It's such a hard one to have because everybody's going to get upset one way or the other. It's just the way it's going to be. There are going to be people who say, well, you don't need a religion in order to be moral. Well, you know what? By definition, that's actually true because morals are the difference between right and wrong. Hence, the cannibals eating people are being great moral people according to their set of morals. So then people came along and said, well, let's just have this this non-violence principle. As long as I'm not going to be violent to you, then live and let live. Okay, well, let's think about that then. So what denotes violence? Physical harm? Well, if that's the case, can I put up a big picture of a naked woman in my yard? Even though you have kids? Well, I guess you could, and it's my responsibility to move then. Well, wait a second. I'm still infringing on you. And, you know, that's part of the conversation that a lot of people don't want to have. That's still infringement. I'm still assaulting your senses. You are seeing it. Well, I don't have to look. Doesn't matter. So the bottom line is when it comes to morals, we have a lot of problems with the conversation itself. Now, obviously, those are some extreme examples, with cannibalism and polygamy being two very extreme examples. But because that moral foundation is so important, and what is a foundation? A foundation is supposed to be something that doesn't move, the foundation of a house holds up the entire house. If that was wishy-washy, if that was weak, the entire house would crumble down. So the importance of a moral foundation is a vital one. But if that foundation can be defined any way we want it to be, then that foundation really isn't secure, and that's what we're witnessing in America. And again, it's a delicate topic, because regardless of which side you're going to stand on, you're going to be mad. Because right now in America, that's what we're doing. We're trying to redefine moral. And as soon as I said that, somebody said, oh, you're talking about gay marriage. No, see, that proves my point. I didn't say anything, and half the audience jumped to the conclusion that I was talking about gay marriage. Why? Because you know as well as I do that we're trying to redefine everything. I didn't say gay marriage. You have people out there who think the community should raise your children. Now, to some people, that's immoral. To those people, it's very moral. To those people, we should raise your children. That's the moral thing to do. And for you to be a parent and think, no, my children belong to me, you're the immoral one. So now what? I mean, if everybody can make up their own definition of moral values, you're both wrong and you're both right. And this is why the larger a community gets, the larger a nation gets, the harder it is to maintain its moral fabric, because people are going to disagree. There are people living in this country right now who are polygamists. Matter of fact, according to estimates, there's a few thousand of them, I guess. I've never met any that I know of, but they don't think they're being immoral. There are groups that think it's okay to lie to you if you don't have their religious faith. So they're not being immoral when they lie to you. Now it breaks your morals. Well, then you have to get into this conversation of, well, wait a second. What if your morals break my morals? Well, hold on. That means you're enforcing your morals upon others. Uh-oh, you have a problem. I thought we couldn't do that. See, this is why people don't really want to have the conversation about morals, because once you start having it, you're led to some very interesting conclusions. And that's why morals have to come from something larger than yourself. You know, people say all the time, well, you know, that's my belief. It doesn't have to be your belief. Those are my moral values. They don't have to be your moral values. And I remember hearing that even way back in school. Well, Josh, that's their morals. Okay, but you know what? We live in a world where we have to deal with each other. We have to interact with each other. What if a man thought it was moral for him to come along and try to pick up your spouse? Well, who are you to say no? I mean, come on, get real. And of course, that's sarcasm. Don't email me. But you have those people who don't think promiscuity is immoral. You have people who are being paid to go tell your college-age daughters to become a whore because it's not immoral anymore. Because we've evolved. We've gotten beyond that. Being a prostitute is a moral thing to do now. Well, who are you to argue? Because, you know, you have the position that everybody's entitled to their own morals. And even if we look at love God and love one another, well, what's the definition of love? I mean, really, honestly, because the same people who can define morals can define love. If love is just the non-aggression principle, well, then to a lot of people, that's not love at all. Leads to an interesting place, doesn't it? We'll be back right after this. You know, it is a very, very tricky conversation to have. It really, truly is. I mean, people have sent us a couple messages over the break. Josh, what's the difference between ethics and morals? Actually, ethics is essentially just a list of morals. Matter of fact, the definition by the Dictionary of Ethics is exactly that, a system of moral principles. The ethics of a culture, the rules of conduct recognized in respect to a particular class of human action or a particular group, culture, etc. So you have this situation where, well, let's take an abortion doctor, for example. And I'm not trying to make this conversation about abortion, just the ethical question, okay? So big boy pants time. A doctor takes an oath to do no harm, right? Well, when he performs an abortion, according to that doctor, he's still doing no harm. See the problem? And then you come along and you're like, no, that's immoral, that's unethical. And he's like, no, it isn't. I'm not harming anybody. Now, who's unethical? And it's easy to say, well, obviously, Josh, the abortion doctor's unethical. Well, according to him and his definition of ethics, he's not doing any harm, so he's not unethical. He's not immoral. Same thing with the, let's say a couple is into watching porn or something together. Are they being unethical? Well, what they do in their own home is up to them. Okay, fine. So according to them, it's moral behavior. Then don't get upset when they teach that moral behavior to your children. No, well, wait, that crosses a line. No, it doesn't. Because we don't live in a cocoon. The ideas are going to be shared. And of course, they're going to defend their ethical behavior. And isn't that really the fight that we're having? It really is. That's the fight we have. Well, it's okay for me and my wife to do this. Whatever we do is not anybody's business. Okay, that's their valid argument. I understand their position. So then they're going to say, it's a good thing to do. It helps improve our marriage. Well, wait a second. They have the moral right to do that. So how dare you protest having a porn store in town? I mean, that's not right for you to do, is it? Huh. So we're caught in a tough position because we want to live a moral life. We don't live on an island. So we're subject to the morals of others, whether we believe it or not. We're impacted by the private morals of others, whether we want to recognize it and admit it or not. So is this conversation about morals an important one? Matter of fact, I think it's probably one of the most important ones, even if we transferred this to politics. Do you think Barack Obama thinks he's doing something bad? And that's the disconnect. People on the other side always think, well, he's got to know he's doing something terrible. No, to him, he's being extremely ethical and moral. To him. To you, he's a nutcase and he's an endangerment to the entire world. But to him, he's ethical. Well, if ethics and morals are up to our own individual definitions, and you recognize that, then any contradiction or any criticism of him beyond today is immoral on your part. You become immoral by your logic if you criticize Obama now. Dangerous conversation. And that's why people don't have it. Because you have this idea, well, you know what? Their morals are up to them. As long as you don't hurt me, and as long as I don't hurt you, then away we go. But it doesn't work that way. It cannot work that way. If you operate your business according to my immorality, but your morality, that infringes upon me whether you want to admit it or not. So then where do we put legislation? And that's where it gets tricky, because then we come along and we try to legislate morality. We try to say, well, okay, well, obviously polygamy is wrong, so let's legislate it. Well, in order to do that, we need to define marriage. Oh, well, see, now that opens a whole can of worms, because as soon as the state gets involved in telling you you are or not married, and you get away from your moral compass from telling you you are or are not married, you now have surrendered your moral compass to the government. Whether you want to admit it or not, it's exactly what you did. And that's why we have the conversation around gay marriage that we're having in this country now. If you really believed that God's definition, according to the Bible, is the definition that you're going to go by, then nothing the Supreme Court does changes it. Nothing. If I believed a bicycle had two wheels and the government came along and said, no, it can have four wheels, does it change my definition? No. But when I yield to the government and say, government, you need to define things for us, so because we're too stupid to do it, can you please define a bicycle? Then I have to change my definition to fit theirs. And of course, that's where the religious side comes in. Are you going to, if you are a religious person, are you living your moral beliefs according to whatever religion you happen to be? And if you are, then you have to be at heads with the state. Because the state is trying to reclassify moral behavior, and not just in gay marriage, in a lot of issues. Food. It's immoral We need to ban soda. We need to ban cigarettes. They even call it a sin tax. Now, really? And, you know, if we went back to the abortion doctors, the abortion doctor trampling on the freedoms and liberties of others, depends on who you ask. According to the doctor, no. According to the baby, yes. But, you know, there's the problem. Is the couple watching porn together trampling on the freedoms of others? Depends on who you ask. That porn store in town that your son has to walk by, well, that answer is yes. But what they do in their own private bedroom, the answer is no. So it depends on who you ask. This whole idea that you're not going to trample on others, I think, is where the problem comes from. I love the idea of everybody has their legal right, and I support that. See, here's the thing. You need to kind of have some experience with this show to grasp my position on this. Some of it has been sarcasm. Some of it has been playing devil's advocate on purpose. Because this, the goal of this show is not to teach you what to think. The goal of this show is to get you thinking. And I hope that makes sense. So there's this rising idea within the liberty truth sort of movement. Well, as long as I don't infringe upon you. Sorry, but that's not possible. And coincidentally, that's exactly the argument used by the anti-smokers. And the smokers. Well, I'm not infringing on you. Well, can I smell the smoke? Well, okay, darn it, I guess I am infringing on you. Okay, so I can't do it in public. Well, now once you admit that that's infringement, well, you know what? You can't do it in a private bar either. Well, bars are private property. Well, not really. I mean, you see where this conversation goes. That's why it's important to have that pillar, that foundation of morals in something larger than yourself. And we have a tendency to look at everything from either an American or a Christian perspective. So let's jump on the other side of the ocean and look at communist China. The whole point of communism is, okay, the state's going to tell you what is ethical. We're going to tell you what's moral. We're going to own the property. Now, communist leaders, do you think that person thinks he's evil? No, of course not. He thinks he's doing the moral thing. He thinks he's doing the right thing. Anyway, I hope that got you thinking. That's the first hour. Let that kind of stir in your head for a while, and we'll be back after this. Don't go anywhere. My plan was to completely end that conversation at the end of the hour. But we got some interesting emails and responses and messages. And if you're not following us on social media, really do so. I mean, it's kind of a fun thing to do. We're on Twitter and Facebook and email, of course, during the breaks. And it gives me an opportunity to see what you guys are thinking and saying. One of the comments was, oh, my gosh, Josh, now I don't know what to think. That was a great point. Well, you know, that's kind of why I did it. Because too often we think what other people tell us to think and we don't think for ourselves. I mean, think about this for real. You know, well, Josh, I'm a Bible believer, so you know, as long as I have my personal relationship, I'm good. Okay, that's cool. How about the mom who told her that she reads the Bible all the time, and God told her to kill her kids because it was the moral thing to do? Well, Josh, death is never moral. Well, wait a second. That's not entirely true. That's not entirely true. I mean, we're bombing innocent civilians in Afghanistan, and we're claiming that it's moral. There were people who were killed in the Bible, and that was moral. So death can be moral, evidently. Infringement on others can be moral, evidently. I'm just giving you a hard time. The point is, I want you to actually think about it, because when we look at what's going on, it's really about that. It really is, and so many of us don't have a moral foundation, that we're just kind of tossed in the wind by whatever happens. And when you look at, you know, union versus non-union, or public school versus state-ran school, you know, a lot of these conversations really come down to a moral conversation. Yet we think it's this superficial issue that the media presents. So I want you to start thinking deeper. I want you to think, okay, what is my moral foundation? What is my moral compass? Am I really going to let all these other people come up with it for me? Especially after listening to the last two segments of the show, realizing, you know what? They're just as messed up. Well, and that leads us to the, well, now, Josh, are you really telling everybody to have their own moral compass and everybody has their individual morals? No, I think there are answers, but I'm not going to give them to you, at least not yet. I want you to search. I want you to think. I want you to process things. And then let me know what you got. Really, honestly. Go to joshtully.com. There's a contact us form. Fill it out. Let me know a week from now how this process has come along for you. All right, so I do want to move on to other stuff. This is from Yahoo.